Harpa Via and Harpa Audio present The Impatient, a novel by Djaili Amadou Amal, translated from the French by Emma Ramadan, performed by Liz Femi. To my husband, Hamadou Baba, and to all our children, love and tenderness. Munyal Defan Heire, patience can cook a stone. Fulani proverb. Ramla. A heart's patience is proportional to its grandeur. Arab proverb. 1. Patience, my girls. Munyal. That is the most valuable component of marriage and of life. That is the true value of our religion, of our customs, of Pulaku, our Fulani identity. Incorporate patience into your future life. Inscribe it in your heart. Repeat it in your mind. Munyal. Don't forget it, my father says. His voice is serious. Head lowered. I am drowning in emotion. My aunts have brought Hindu and I into our father's apartment. Outside, the effervescence of the double wedding is in full swing. The cars are already parked. The in-laws are waiting, impatient. The children, excited by the festivities, shout and dance around the cars. Our friends and younger sisters, unaware of our anguish, stand by our sides. They envy us, dreaming of the day when they will be the queens of the party. The griots are here, accompanied by lute and tambourine players. They sing words of praise at the top of their lungs in honor of the family and the new sons-in-law. My father is seated on his favorite sofa. He calmly sips a cup of clove tea. Hayatu and Umaru, my uncles, are also present, surrounded by a few close friends. These men are supposed to pass on their final words of advice, list our future duties as wives, and then say their goodbyes, after granting us their blessings. Munyal, my girls, for patience is a virtue. God loves those who are patient, my father repeats, imperturbable. Today, I have achieved my duty as your father. I raised you, instructed you, and today I entrust you to these responsible men. You are now big girls, women. Henceforth, you are married and owe respect and consideration to your husbands. I adjust my coat around me. It's a sumptuous alkibare. I am sitting next to my sister Hindu at our father's feet on a bright red Turkish rug that contrasts sharply with our dark dresses. We are surrounded by our aunts, who, designated as our elder kamo, fulfill the roles of maids of honor. As with every marriage, Gogo Nene, Gogo Dia, and their acolytes have enormous difficulty masking their emotion. Only their sniffling disturbs the silence. Tears dig deep grooves in their wrinkled cheeks. They don't attempt to hide their red eyes. Through us, they relive their own weddings. They too were brought to their fathers for a final goodbye and received the customary advice passed down from generation to generation with each new bride. Munyal, my girls, says my uncle Hayatu. Then he pauses and clears his throat before listing orders in a solemn tone. Respect your 5 daily prayers. Read the Quran so that your progeny will be blessed. Fear your God. Spare your minds from distraction. Be for him a slave, and he will be your captive. Be for him the earth, and he will be your sky. Be for him a field, and he will be your rain. Be for him a bed, and he will be your hut. Do not sulk. Do not look down on a gift. Do not return it. Do not be bad-tempered. Do not be talkative. Do not be scatterbrained. Do not beg, do not demand. Be modest, be grateful, be patient, be discreet. Valorize him so that he will honor you. Respect his family and submit to them so that they will support you. Aid your husband. Preserve his fortune. Preserve his dignity. Preserve his appetite. May he never starve because of your laziness, your bad mood, or your bad cooking. Spare his sight, his hearing, his sense of smell. May his eyes never be confronted by anything dirty in your food or in your house. May his ears never hear obscenities or insults coming from your mouth. May his nose never smell anything that reeks in your body or in your house. May he breathe in only perfume and incense. These words lodge in my mind. I feel my heart break, realizing that my worst nightmare is coming to life. Up to the last minute, naively, I had hoped that a miracle would spare me from this hardship. A powerless, mute rage strangles me. I desire to smash everything, to cry, to scream. My sister stops holding back her tears and sobs, suffocates. I reach for her hand and squeeze it to comfort her. Faced with her distress, I feel strong despite my pain. Now that I am being separated from her, Hindu is all the more dear to me. May your parents never learn of anything unpleasant in your household. Keep your conjugal conflicts to yourself. Do not cultivate dislike between your two families, for you will reconcile, but the hatred you sow will last, adds Uncle Hayatu. After a moment of silence, my father continues in the same solemn and authoritative tone. Starting now, you each belong to your husband and owe him total submission, as decreed by Allah. Without his permission, you do not have the right to leave the house or even to visit my bedside. Only by following this rule will you be successful wives. Uncle Umaru, who had kept quiet up to this point, continues. Always remember, to please her husband, every time they meet, a wife must perfume herself with the most precious perfume. Adorn herself in the most beautiful attire. Ornament herself with jewelry and much more. A woman's paradise is at her husband's feet. He pauses, as if to give us time to reflect, then turns toward his younger brother and concludes. Hayatu, complete the dua. Speak the prayer. May Allah grant them happiness, honor their household with numerous children, and give them the baraka. Finally, may Allah grant every father the joy of seeing his daughter married. Ameen, my father responds. Then he addresses my aunts. Go now, the cars are waiting. Gogo Nene elbows me. In a muffled voice, I thank my father, then my uncles. To everyone's surprise, Hindu throws herself in tears at the feet of our stunned father and begs, Please, Baba, listen to me. I don't want to marry him. Please, let me stay here.
What is this nonsense, Hindu?
I don't love Mubarak, she says, sobbing even harder. I don't want to marry him. My father barely glances at the teenager hunched at his feet. Turning toward me, he utters calmly, Go! May Allah grant them happiness. And it's over. That's the only goodbye I receive from my father, whom I will probably not see again for another year, if everything goes according to plan. At that moment, despite the distance that has always existed between us, I wanted my father to speak to me, to tell me he was going to miss me. I hoped he would assure me of his love, murmur that I would always be his little girl, that this house would always be mine, and that I would still be welcome here. But I know that such things are unrealistic, We aren't in one of those foreign TV series that inspired our teenage dreams, nor in one of those soppy novels that so delighted us. We are neither the first nor the last girls that my father and uncles will marry off. On the contrary, they are content to have seamlessly accomplished their duty. Since our childhood, they have waited for this moment when they could finally offload their responsibilities by entrusting us, still virgins, to other men. My aunt leads us, completely veiled, toward the exit. There are so many women waiting for us in the large courtyard that my hand loses Hindu's. I cannot say a word to her. Already, amid the ululation, I am brought to the car awaiting me. A final glance, and I see her, in tears, distraught. She is shoved into the second car. 2. For the whole drive, per the custom, I am accompanied by shouts of joy. The luxurious black Mercedes I'm sitting in advances ahead of dozens of others, horns blaring. The procession drives around the city before entering a magnificent compound, gleaming with colorful lights. The sounds of tom-toms and the songs of griots blend with the yoo-yoos of overexcited women and children, creating an incredible cacophony. An hour later, my co-wife comes to welcome me. I stare at her from beneath my veil. Contrary to how I had imagined her, she is not old. She's in the prime of her 30s, a woman of great beauty. I hope to ally myself with her, but the look she gives me forbids it. She seems to detest me before even knowing me. She too is surrounded by the women of her family, who all display polite smiles. The two camps stare each other down, scrutinizing each other in a tacit duel, barely concealing a honeyed contempt. My co-wife is dressed like a bride, a sparkling pannier wrapper, her beautiful braids, hand and feet decorated with henna. But I can tell that she's making an enormous effort to remain calm. Her lips form a slight smile that does not hide the sadness of her eyes. They say she sank into depression upon the announcement of this marriage, that she spent entire days crying. She must have come around thanks to the support of her family. Or did she simply concede that nothing and no one could dissuade her husband from this marriage that all the city was mocking? Her eyes examine me, pierce through me. Our gazes meet, and the hatred I read in hers makes me lower mine. My elder sister-in-law, highly regarded by other women, addresses my co-wife. My dear Safira, here is the new bride, your Amaria. Her name is Ramla. She is your younger sister, your little one, your daughter. Her family entrust her to you. You must help her now by passing down your advice, by showing her the ways of the compound. You are the first wife, the Dadasare. And as you know, the Dadasare is the guide of the house, the one who ensures the harmony of the home. Dadasare, you will also be the punching bag of the house. You will keep your place as Dadasare even if your husband marries 10 others. So, a single word, Munyal, patience. For everything depends on you. You are the pillar of the house. It's up to you to make the effort to be resilient and conciliatory. In order to be so, you will have to practice perfect self-control from now on. Munyal, you, Safira, the Dadasare, Jidere Sare, the mother, the mistress of the home, and the punching bag of the household. Munyal, Munyal. Then she turns toward me. Ramla, you are now Safira's little sister, her daughter, and she is your mother. You owe her obedience and respect. You will entrust yourself to her, ask her advice, follow her orders. You are the younger sister. You will not take any initiative to do with the management of the compound without the approval of your Dada Sare. She is the mistress of the house. You are only her little sister. Your job is the thankless tasks. Absolute obedience, patience before her anger. Respect. Munyal, Munyal. We listen in silence, nodding our heads in a sign of acquiescence.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.